The archaeological research of the last decades revealed that around the start of the Middle Iron Age, at the end of the 7th century BC, the territories of northeastern Hungary, western Slovakia, and the eastern part of today's Czech Republic were hit by an extensive series of attacks. Today, approximately 20 fortified settlements are known, where bronze arrowheads found along pristine hillfort walls bear witness to devastating sieges that occurred almost simultaneously. The most famous of these sites is Smolenice or Somolaj in western Slovakia, where the excavations brought to light altogether 373 arrowheads and the remains of numerous slaughtered humans laying amongst the ruins of the fortifications and the burned-down buildings. The most spectacular evidence of this early Iron Age attack series in the territory of Hungary is the fortified settlement at Dédestapolcsány-Verebce. The prehistoric settlement is situated on the northern fringe of the Bükk Mountains. Its surface is divided by several earthworks. Our team investigated the area and the first arrowheads were discovered in the course of a metal detector survey trip. The majority of the arrowheads, altogether 340 pieces, were distributed in a closed patch, not more than 100 meters long, along the northern wall of the hillfort protecting a gate. The siege might have been successful here, as several arrows were shot inside the settlement, and the area of the pristine buildings was full of burnt and molten bronze objects. The attackers were identified by the special bronze arrowheads they used. These types appear first after the turn of the 9th and 8th centuries BC as part of the weaponry of horse nomadic communities occupying the Eurasian steppe. Their emergence is probably connected with the coeval mass spread of the recurve bow. The analysis of the arrowheads suggests that the types used in the siege of the hill fort at Verebce were used by warrior communities living in the territories of Transylvania along the upper course of the river Maros and in the forest steppe zone east of the Carpathian Mountains by the middle coast of the Dniester. The experiment presented in this video attempted to answer several questions. As there is no archaeological evidence on the position of the attackers and the details of the attack, the first question was, how far the lines of the attacking archers were positioned from the walls? The second question was about the damage observed on the arrowheads. What materials did they hit and what caused their deformations? Many of them were bent or broken. And molten ones were also found, suggesting perhaps that the attackers tried to set fire to the walls during the siege. The experiment was conducted in three stages. First, the replica bows and arrows were created, along with some targets made of different materials. The second phase was a test shot performed on the site where the arrowheads were found in order to learn about the shooting range of the arrow and the possible position of the attackers. The third stage was an analysis of the damage on the arrowheads to clear the marks left by having been shot from arrows of diverse strength, from various distances, and hitting different surfaces. Three types of the arrowheads discovered at Verebce were chosen for the test shooting. Type 1C is a two-edged arrowhead with a hexagonal blade shape. Type 2F is a three-edged, so-called trilobite bodkin, with outer socket and a thorn, and type 2B is a short, three-edged, inner-socketed variant. Lostwick's technique was used to cast 9 copies of each type. The copies were made of bronze with 12% tin content. The arrowheads were fastened with lime glue to the shafts. Some of the shafts were cut into a length of 50 centimeters, which is a standard length for Scythian arrows appearing both in the written sources and among archaeological finds. But with the majority of the arrows, longer shafts were used in order to facilitate their repeated use and repair. Several arrow shaft remains are known from contemporaneous sites in the Eurasian steppe zone. Their material shows great diversity, as birch, poplar, willow, ash and pine were equally used. The water drop shaped barreled arrows in the experiment were made of pine and linden. Just like the Scythian arrowheads in general, the ones found at Verebce-tető were rather narrow-socketed. This means that the shaft's end must be cut into a conic shape, thus significantly raising the possibility of breaking. To reinforce the fastening, the arrowheads were wrapped around tightly with glued deer tendon at the socket. Both ends of the fletching were also reinforced the same way. The fletching of the reconstructed barreled arrows was made of turkey and white goose wing quills. The selection of Scythian bow types for the experiment was deliberate, and the three chosen specimens represent diverse structural variants. The first bow was reconstructed based on meager archaeological evidence from the Pontic region. Its body consists of a wooden core covered with glued-on layers of horn and tendon. The second piece is a functional copy of the bow found in a burial in the Argentu grave mound in Tuva. It is built up of a core comprising multiple wooden slabs glued together and covered with layers of horn and tendon. The third bow is also based on an actual archaeological find from Subashi in China. It consists of thin wooden slabs glued together and layered with horn and horn intermixed with tendon. Three targets were built to represent diverse parts of the Iron Age hill fort. One to imitate the hardwood palisade wall, another consisting of compacted soil with stones for the earthworks foot wall and the inlay of the palisade, and the third one for water structures of the breastwork. The water target was covered by a raw cattle skin, as the defenders probably used a similar technique to protect these surfaces from burning arrows. As our goal was to investigate the damage of the arrowheads, the shots were fired from a range of 6 meters. The experiment has proven to be rather informative. The post-wall structure of the palisade offered excellent protection against Scythian arrows. Many of them bounced off and almost all the rest broke upon impact. One of the bounced-off arrows flew back as much as 5 meters, while many of the impacted ones penetrated the oaken post as deep as 1.5 to 2 centimeters. Only one of these was successfully retrieved, and the arrowhead showed no damage. When covered with cattle skin, the wattle has also proven to be successful in capturing the shots, but without a cover, it was quite ineffective, and type 2F arrowheads were even able to break through it. A damage of the arrowheads was only visible in one case. The tip of a type 2B arrowhead became chipped. The arrowheads suffered the greatest damage upon impacting on the compacted soil and stone target. Some of them penetrated the soil as deep as 21 centimeters, but a couple of millimeters broke off the tip of the two-edged ones, while the tip of a type 2F arrowhead became highly bent when the arrow hit a stone. The head broke off at the end of the socket with the majority of the arrows, while in some cases the shaft simply detached the head. Upon extracting the head of the arrows, penetrating the soil remained stuck without exception. The test shots of the experiment suggest that during the siege, the arrows shot into the compacted, stony soil of the hillfort walls became damaged or lost in the highest numbers. Probably also many became stuck in the posts and narrow gaps of the palisade walls, but many bounced off the wooden surfaces and fell into the moat. Previous experiments reveal that the maximal shooting range of a Scythian type bow is about 130-140 meters, while the optimal angle for long-distance shooting is 45 degrees. During the test shooting at Verebce-tető, it was not possible for us to stick to these ideal parameters, as the assumed position of the attackers was much lower than that of the defenders. Thus, the arrows shot behind the pristine palisade walls of the hill fort impacted at a distance of maximum 100 meters suggest that the arrowheads found inside the settlement, 200 to 300 meters away from the walls, did not arrive from outside, but were shot by the incoming attackers.